everyone, it's Adrian. I'm redoing this because I couldn't find my phone and I was getting a call. So I should have known that I put it on the charger. But I am going to show you a couple of things that I have right now that maybe you guys might be interested in seeing. So I could show you my shirt too, or my sweater. I thought it was going to be colder out, but it was pretty hot because you can hear the AC blasting. So I was going to say, I'm going to make other videos. I've been holding off my top 10, maybe even top 15, because I think I take it too seriously. I really want them to be like my ultimate top decks. So I know people do at the moment, but I really want to feel like those are going to be my forever decks. I'll probably do decks that I'm working with right now, and they'll be easier because I feel like I'll be betraying myself if I mention a deck right now and then it turns out that it's not going to be like my top 10 or top whatever. I'm also going to do a product launch this weekend, and I've been talking about it mainly on this channel because it's been so low-key since I haven't really discussed it anywhere else, but I'm saying it and putting it off because I want to get this right. So I'm going to show these two wands first because I usually show other types of witchy things, especially my witchy hauls from mainly thrift stores and also tarot decks. So these are two wands that are from a YouTuber. She made them herself, and you can also get wands done if you like to do that because she's awesome. I really love her. I've been watching her for years. She's really insightful. She talks about a lot of different types of things regarding spirituality, angels, fairies, Ekinthar. She even talks about like how money, she talks a lot about astral projection and different planes, the Akashic records. So I really wanted a wand from her because I've been watching her for so long, and like I'm almost like fangirling about it. But I've been holding them off, I keep saying that, because I'm not the best with things, so when I get stuff, it usually becomes my own, and you really notice it, because, say, my Sacred Paths book, you know, how it's, like, green colors, it's already getting dirty. Basically, things get kind of destroyed when I have them, but I still love them, and I hope she doesn't get mad. That's probably the main reason. But this is the Root Chakra wand. This is also a sexuality wand. So you can see the sparkles, and there's black too. I take this because it fell off, but they're two cherries for the sexuality part of it. And she did write a note about the herbs, which is the herb, which is Damiana, and this is for sexual potency too. She also wrote me a card, and if I could pause, if I were able to pause on this tablet, then I would get the card, but I can't pause on this. But they match what she has here, which is like two birth fairy from this pine tree, just so sweet. They had pineapples. There were pineapples on the cards. I'm sorry, like correcting myself all the time. But this is a vegetation wand. I like to refer this as a herbalist wand or a gardening wand. She has a gardening wand too, and she utilized what she had or was able to find, which is a back scratcher, if you didn't notice, and she made it into something that you can use for more types of uses. So my cats did eat a little bit of the herbs that were on here, but I'm surprised. surprised they didn't really get into the catnip. I think because it was sealed so much. Because I did put it up to their nose and they were able to snip it out, but they weren't able to get to it. So this is so pretty. I know what I'm doing with these wands, and it just came to me before I was filming the first video. This is the second video. And I really like how I can hang. But I may do that with one of them because I'll be using them for something specific that I'll show you guys soon. So, as I said, I'm showing you some stuff. I think I said, because this is my second tape, that I was going to show you decks. To my surprise, I've been getting a lot of Oracle decks lately, which doesn't usually happen. I don't really work with Oracle decks that much, and I keep saying Tarot is more Oracle, but it's okay. I really do like them. I think because I don't use them as much, I don't see the point of purchasing them so much. And I do usually have like prices. Like, I don't think I would spend over $30. I don't even think I've spent $30 on a deck, on an Oracle deck. Probably 15 to 20, around that. So this is a Tarot swap from Better Be Quiet Now. She's on Instagram. She has a couple of Battery decks, or decks that you can that maybe you guys would be interested in. So I'll be posting this picture and the other deck that I have on my Instagram, because I want to thank her too. And I thanked her already, but I'll post something more. So as I said, I don't usually spend a lot of money on Oracles, but if I really want them, then I think I would spend the money for this deck. Again, the sacred symbols for divination and meditation, if I didn't say that. 2013 to 2015, Marcella Kroll. It's the same on the front and on the back and also on the booklet too. The booklet does have brief descriptions about the symbol and the interpretation that she has. Sometimes the inside has pictures, but this one doesn't. It's a very smooth, laminated packaging, as well as the book. The book kind of gives it a better quality magazine material. I like how it says this deck belongs to. There, I'll write my name. How to use the deck. I've only opened this for once I for myself, but I do like shorter interpretations for cards because I think I've said this before, I get bored easily, so I don't usually stay interested if it's too long, or I like start to skim through it and I don't like skimming through stuff. So the sacred symbols though, I am for the other deck, I'll explain later. But this is the card that she has, black on black. That's okay. I like the simplicity of it. Sometimes decks have descriptions at the bottom. It's a little distracting for me. A little, probably a lot. So I don't usually get ones like that. I got two. The first two cards that I got were Talisman. Talisman is actually the one that I turned to when I first opened the book. And that has a key on it. That has a description saying it's like to Hecate in this book specifically. And I also got Focus. So, Talisman was what I got in the book. And then, bottom of the deck was actually Talisman 2 when I pulled out Focus. Focus, I may have shown already, I'm not sure. Because it's weird when... Well, this is Talisman, by the way. Well, I may have shown, but I wasn't paying attention. It's strange how, like, you're just flipping through the cards and sometimes you... Because even when you watch some videos, there's some reversals, and some people don't mind showing them upside down. I usually, this is what it is, flip them over. So I'll show, this is the last one. Oh, cool. This was my card of the day. Because I usually, like, at the end, I count to three, and that would be the last card. So, again, the sacred symbols for divination and meditation. Sorry, that's one of my cats, the little one. Another deck that I have is the Animal Wise Tarot by Ted Andrews. I've been holding off from this deck because, well, I tried looking at the demo, but I didn't like the energy of the demo. And it's also strange because sometimes you shouldn't, well, I feel like I shouldn't touch the demo because it had so many people touch it. While this deck is, it does match with my energy well. And I really wanted a deck that had real pictures of animals. I've been really into animals and different types of shamanic workings. For retail reference, I didn't know that this was the price. It was $34.95 because sometimes I don't have the price for the cards. I do like getting them in person to feel them out and to see them. But I do like getting the cheaper price too. It's okay. So, it opens up like this. I didn't realize that this deck was made by Ted Andrews, who wrote the Animal Speak book. This is my second copy, because I loved the one that I had, and it was only $2, $2.95 at a thrift store. He keeps it really interesting. It does have categories of the animals, and even insects, and reptiles, mammals, and there's a section for birds, too, shape-shifting, different stories, and other chapters that I'm not touching upon. So I know that I'm really going to like this book. I don't know, I like reading about animals, maybe, or I like the way that he writes, too. I do like the way he writes, but I don't know what, I don't want to say what's up with the bats, but I'm thinking if it's coming from a publishing company, it kind of looks like it's self-published because the cards aren't aligned. This is what they come in, which is actually pretty nice for them because it's a little loose for you to take them out, but it's not too loose. Dragon Hawk Publishing. And again, the backings, I'm probably going to etch this black because it does feel like a little bit of a Mary deck. They did have the animal, I'm sorry, the feather omen. Getting a little distracted. I do like the keywords on here. And I'll shuffle a little bit. I do like the cardstock. It's a little thin. And another thing about feeling like it's self-published, like he did the work himself, is because some of the cards are reversed. I'm not sure if they were meant to be reversed. And maybe, like, some of the cards I saw that they were kind of bent and even had dents and wrinkles. I don't know if you know what I'm talking about with wrinkles, but it was weird. I don't care that much though, because I'm probably going to do something to it anyway. I really love the pictures that it has. I got used to the circles because I don't mind them, but I'm a little surprised that they don't have the whole picture for the cards, but that's for the writing too. I thought that it's really clever. I think that's really clever for the suits. It's the Seven of Ancients, and that's the Wands with Fire. I like that because if you're talking about energy, energy can't be destroyed, it can only be transformed, so I think it's clever. Shapeshifters are insects, so the five shapeshifters, water, cups, earthworm. I really do like the keywords at the bottom. I think that they work well, and they're not your normal ones either, not like your the ones that you traditionally see. So I really hope that my neighbors aren't doing anything that's burning, because I smell smoke. But the shapeshifters for water, because water is fluid and like flowy, and also like, when I say movement, taking on different shapes. I'm thinking about Ditto from Pokemon. It's kind of weird, but as Pokemon I remember. So I got it mainly for the coyote picture, because I've been getting that one a lot. In the Sacred Path cards, I kept getting the Heyoka, and he's linked to the coyote medicine. I hope I'm saying his name right. And the winged ones are birds, so that would be air. I've been getting lovers a lot lately, and I've been getting the Eight of Wands. I think it's been an Eight of Wands type of month for me, at least. And the medicine cards, they do have the white ones, and they have it for this one too. So I think that's cool. But I love the coyote. I'm also Year of the Dog, by the way, and I love bison too. I say all the suits. I'm sorry. I really smell smoke, so I'm kind of nervous. I didn't even see Justice. I'm also a Libra. Libra Sun, Virgo Rising, and Scorpio Moon. I think maybe I said the Four Legs, the Pentacles, but I'm not sure. But I'm thinking about just blacking out the backs or doing something on my own with them. I tried to ignore them because as messy as I am, I do have things that I really like to have done. See, like there's a wrinkle here, it looks like stitches, and I don't know, maybe it wasn't even tightly bound with the packaging, so I'm kind of surprised, but it's okay. So one. Any cards are bad. I think it's more for improvements. Anyway, so thank you so much for watching just in time because I'm getting a call on my